FIFA 20 demo gameplay, so let's jump right into it. Where are we at on the clock for counting down the days till FIFA 20? 10 days. 10 days until FIFA 20 is officially released on physical copy. Not sure about digital. I always like to buy everything physical for just multiple reasons, but... Sorry friends, battery died a lot quicker than I thought, but where was I? Oh yeah, that's right, we're selecting teams. There's two teams I haven't played as yet, Dortmund and Chelsea, so I'll play with each of those in turn for the next couple games. Who am I going to play against? Can't play against Chelsea. Why not? I'll play against Dortmund. But yeah, just having a ton of fun doing this, so figured I'd bring you guys a little bit more of that specific content. So funny, Giroud, Pedro, and Willian are all starting in the game. However, Pulisic, Mount, and Abraham are starting in their place. Coincidence? Maybe. Well, they actually have a pretty solid reserve. Jorginho, solid player. Conte, monster. Why these I don't know why those two aren't switched. Let's see, Conte can really do it all. Switch him and no. We'll switch him and Jorginho. There we go. Okay, we'll go right back into it then. Alright, let's play one. Not on semi-pro AI though, that's boring. World class is, like, as long as I'm getting used to the game, world class seems to be the move, so we'll keep it going. Olivier Giroud. Advanced shooting bronze, give me a moment guys. And girls, sorry, I just gotta respond to a text. Alright, let's actually try this drill out. Oh, I remember this one. Seems like a good time for the finesse shot. Time finishing, I notice, is a little bit better in this game than it was in previous years. I don't know if it's because the bar actually appears a little bit more obviously. I don't know. But I'm still kind of surprised they kept time finishing in. Maybe they're just giving it another year. We'll see. Gotta change up the camera angle and turn off this trainer. I'm really upset because in FIFA 18 you could just click the right thumbstick and the trainer disappeared. Now that is no longer the case. Don't know why they decided to make it you had to go into the trainer itself and switch it. It's just so annoying because every time I play with friends, you gotta go in and change the trainer again. Plus I gotta turn down my TV. It's quite loud from where I'm sitting. Anyway. This is where it all begins in Europe's Premier Club competition, the UEFA Champions League. Oh, whoops. Shake and bake. I forgot Mateo Kovacic came from Real Madrid to Chelsea like two seasons ago. Power move by Chelsea? Yeah, I don't know. Was it a bad move? No. By no means was it a bad move. Power move, though, I guess that remains to be seen. All right, Mateo. Not a bad shot. Not a bad start. I wanted to land a bicycle kick right here. Ooh, no pass back to the keeper? Of course not, it doesn't happen in FIFA. Software doesn't allow for such atrocities. If you guys haven't checked out my review of the demo, feel free to. It's up on the channel right now. Otherwise, it's on YouTube. The link for my YouTube channel is somewhere in the description of my Twitch stream as well. So if you guys have some time, feel free to check it out. I guess if I had to give you a quick summary, overall I think FIFA 20 is an improvement. Better goalkeeper play, more fluid movements, better dribbling mechanics. Time finishing is a little bit better. Cons, through balls aren't as effective. I guess you could say they're a little bit more natural, a little bit more smooth, but because they're more realistic, they're a little less effective. You gotta kind of test it out to see what I'm saying, but what other things? Passing is about the same. I think the biggest passing change I've seen in FIFA was from 18 to 19. That was quite an adjustment. Ooh, what a shot. I guess it's probably Royce. Yeah, of course, that's Royce. It's the first time I've ever played with Chelsea in a FIFA game. I don't know why, I just can't stand Chelsea. Me being a United fan, I guess I shouldn't like any of the other top six teams, but for some reason Chelsea's good, and I got a heart of stone when it comes to Chelsea. I just hope they lose every game. Yeah, poor pass at best. I think it's fair to say, Lee, when you talk about teams that could win the UEFA Champions League... Oh yeah, that's another thing I'm just remembering too. So for telebroadcast, the angle for the camera moves a little bit more slowly than in the past. Usually it would do a pretty good job of staying right on top of everything, but now it kind of lags behind a little bit, which is fine. Not a huge deal, but things I wish they would do... this might also be a couple cons. So there's a bug in the game that's existed since like FIFA 17 where... if you're throwing the ball and you try to make a quick throw to your left, like right after the screen pops up and you're about to throw in, if you try to make a quick throw to your left, the software for some reason will bug out and you'll throw it to your right where nobody's standing, and it's infuriating as hell because you're just trying to, you know, get that throw in, but kind of tough. But yeah, they haven't fixed it in years, and I'm shocked that, I mean, I haven't heard any other streamers or players mention it. Maybe I should ask other players and streamers in a little bit more detail what they think about it, but... or maybe it's just my system. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know what would happen if I change it over to a new system. All I know is when I'm playing against my friends, it drives me nuts. Another critique I have is, so you know that fixed camera angle that they have for goal kicks that kind of mask where you're going to kick the ball? Yeah, I wish they'd do that for all free kicks, or they'd allow you to do that for all free kicks, because there are definitely some points where I'm playing against opponents and I'm like, yeah, I really don't want them to see where my free kick is going. And the reason why I say they should at least switch between a fixed angle and a dynamic angle where you can move your camera is because when you're shooting, when you're like within 20 yards of the goal and you got a free kick, you want to be able to adjust where your shot is. So it's kind of the exception to that rule, if y'all know what I'm saying. But yeah, the movements in this game are a lot more realistic, flexible. It kind of reminds me of PES, Pro Evolution Soccer, for those of you who don't know what that is. It's kind of like the... picture it as like... I don't want to say it's off-brand FIFA, because it's much more than that, but that's the only way I can describe it in truth. It's like they have all the same mechanics as FIFA, except the gameplay is probably a little bit better, a little bit more fluid, a little bit more dynamic. But like they don't have like a lot of licenses for teams, so it's like at one point when I was playing PES 2017 or whatever, they had Arsenal named North London. They had like a green logo. It was just weird. But there's things in PES that you can do that you can't do in FIFA that kind of outweigh the costs. So pros and cons, just like anything else. I feel like I'm running around like a madman this game. Yeah, so you're heading in, the movement's a little bit more realistic. Like, players will take, like, appropriate angles to head balls in such directions and whatnot. I feel like in 19 it was like, oh, they put their whole body into it and they're good. Not how it really works. Oh, why didn't I just pass it off to Giroud, who's sitting right there? Every shot I've had has just been absolutely fluffed, like straight into the crowd. The reason why I'm playing the demo so much is so I can adjust for when the physical copy comes out and I'm playing it all the time. Like for Ultimate Team, I want to be able to be used to this kind of thing before I even start playing, rather than just diving right into it. When I first started playing 19, oh, it was a nightmare. It was an absolute nightmare. Convincing defensively. Now Giroud. Kovacic. Oh, there it is. I think I've done that so many times, it's disgusting. Yeah, a little bit too much power. Yeah, I've done that a ton, it seems like, in the last... I mean, if you guys watched my gameplay from yesterday and my demo review from 2 days before, you'll see me hit the post, I'm pretty sure, at least 3 times total, if not more, and that was the fourth. So, nature of the beast. The ball with Marco Reus. Notice too, among all these Champions League teams, the 4-3-3 is so popular, especially with whether it be false nine, whether it be defensive, whether it be an attacking 4-3-3. It's just so common. The only team I've seen that doesn't really do it is PSG, and they have like a 3-5-2, but they have two winged backs, so it's kind of like a 5-3-2 or whatever. It's the strangest formation I've ever seen, but actually, no, Dortmund usually has some pretty weird formations. They'll do like a 4-3-3, but they'll have both their center attacking mids like misaligned. It's so strange. I don't understand the motivation behind it, but hey, I'm not the manager, so what do I know? Sweet, alright, William. It's the only time you'll ever hear me say that phrase. Friends, it's the only time you'll ever hear me say it. Way to go, William. Man, I need some water after this game. For some reason, my throat is just dry. It was really funny the other day. I was like trying to figure out. I'm like, man, where's United? Where are they at? Ah. Like, where are they at in the demo? And I realized, I'm like, oh yeah, that's they didn't qualify for the Champions League, so they're obviously not gonna be in the demo. So sad face for me, right? They'll be in the Europa League. I don't really know how to feel about the Europa League. I'm excited that they're in a European competition, but of course, you always want Champions League. But I'm kind of glad that I became a United fan when they started to kind of drop off after Sir Alex Ferguson retired, because then I don't get stink from people. They're like, oh man, you're a Man United fan. You're just, you know, bandwagon. It's like, no, I started being a Man United fan when they were falling apart with Louis van Gaal and they haven't been playing too well. And I'd argue that even with Louis van Gaal, they were playing fine. Not great, but they were playing fine. They'd win games. Score. Yeah, a little too slow. Yeah, I'll let that one go. And a throw in forthcoming. Axel Witsel. That was an interesting little pass. Top of the situation to get the ball back for his team. Sancho now. Delaney. High press seems to be a little bit more effective because of the dynamic player movement. Oh boy. I should stop controlling my center backs. That's a problem. It's an issue. Way to go, Azpilicueta. Oh no, Aretha Balaga, sorry. How did I get that wrong? It's definitely Aretha Balaga. Everybody move upfield. I love Kepa's name. Aretha Balaga, it's like, I don't know, something about it just rolls off the tongue quite nicely. It's weird because he's got some Z's and he's got some P's and he's got some, you know. He's got it all on his name. It's quite a name. All right, well, another draw. Now I'll kind of switch it up. Now I'll play with Dortmund and then face off whatever random team I happen to draw. Yeah, like I said, guys, overall, I like the gameplay a little bit better. I think FIFA's starting to get a little bit more loose with their player movements, which I said is a little bit more dynamic, a little bit more realistic, which, you know, just something gamers got to get used to, like myself. No right or wrong to it, it's just fact. We're not playing. Okay, we'll play Liverpool, why not? That's an interesting matchup. Liverpool lost today in the Champions League against Napoli. I was kind of surprised, but yeah, see, this is what I'm saying. Brandt and Royce are like... Brandt's lower down the pitch than Royce, I never understood it, but... Hey, I'm cool with it. Witsel's perfect. Sancho, he was going to become a United Red. I would have killed to have him on our squad right now. Really interesting. Are we playing at the Bernabeu? No, we're not. We'll play at Tottenham Stadium. Why not? Yeah, we're not playing at the Bernabeu. I think the Bernabeu is just such an overhyped stadium. There's nothing architecturally pleasing about it. Oh, yes. See what they did to free kicks this time around. Can't tell if I like it or not. I kind of like the old way they did free kicks. Maybe that's another critique, I guess. Because now I got to learn a whole new system. I guess I'll just kind of stick with what I know here. Just over the wall. Oh, there's a way you can kind of delete. Ooh, wow. Yeah, I wonder if there's a way you can kind of revert to the old way. That's interesting. Just so much easier the other way. Yeah, not bad. See, how do you shoot under, you know? Yeah, you really don't. Try the side spin. Oh, not bad. Try the side spin again. Yeah, a little too much sauce. Knuckleball, yes. Oh, that knuckle's got some knuckle on it, let me tell you. Can I, like, adjust their movement? No. Yep, there goes that. Okay, we'll move on. Interesting, though, now for set pieces, they kind of changed up the dynamics almost completely, so we'll see how it goes. Alright, let's hit my preferences from last time out. Firmino read me like a book. Bobby. Bobby, hit the lights. This is where it all begins in Europe's Premier Club competition, the UEFA Champions League, the group stage. Julian Brandt's on my 19 Ultimate Team. It's kind of a shame because I'm pretty sure FIFA 19 Ultimate Team is just gone now because they shut it down to focus on 20. Makes sense though, I mean 10 days, it's coming out. Gotta have it, gotta have it. Oh, yep, there goes that. Yeah, it's just an unfortunate little sequence of events right there. Let's keep her going. Underway once more. Liverpool have the lead. I don't know why. I've had an English accent stuck in my head like the last 2-3 days. It's just so soothing and appealing to hear. If I tried imitating it right now, I'd probably sound like shit, so I won't imitate it. Who knows, maybe it'll get the best of me and I just won't be able to help myself. It's kind of like that meme on Twitter if y'all haven't seen it. It's like, don't say it, don't say it, and then English accent. Love English accents. I just went to England almost a year ago now. Wow, about 9 months ago. And when I came back, I'm like, man, why isn't everybody talking the way I think they're going to talk? And I'm like, oh yeah, it's because we're back in America. thought John had the pace. Really charging up at everybody. Keep it going. Get up, Axel. Axel Witzel, I love his abnormally large hair. He's got quite the fro going. Alexander Arnold. Si, senor. Apparently that's a song by Liverpool fans about Bobbert Firmino. Taken short. Hate the damn short corner. Disadvantage Liverpool here. Henderson. Now he must favor the cross. Ooh, dangle me. Useful ball to the near. There you go. And behind it goes the concession of a corner here. They've taken this corner short. Henderson. Here's Salah. Well, body in the way. What a save, son. Go, Jadon Sancho. There you go. Axel Witzel. Can they hit on the break? Witzel. Sancho. Oh, hey. Dortmund have been awarded the free. Oy. He's been admonished by the referee. Interesting. He's now got to walk something of a tightrope. Yeah, he knows exactly where he stands. Well, look, looks like I can't shoot from here because they're making me pick this camera angle. Man, I'm being really nitpicky at this point. No, I'm digging this. Let's try it. And the cross sent in by no dice. To get it out of there. Here's Robertson. Liverpool have given it away. And
voice getting higher up the pitch as the attack continues.
Yeah, right at Allison. No good.
Well, Derek, the stats tell you everything. Slim pickings out there, not created enough. I can't see them getting back in this game unless their forwards up their game a little bit.
Let it fly, baby.
It wasn't far away from the target, Lee.
No, it was decent. Really, really decent chance for the lad. They'll keep pushing away to try and get that equaliser.
Brandt. Sancho now. Well, they continue their push for the equaliser, but definitely not forcing it.
Nah.
Reading of the game to win possession back.
It's me trying to be cheeky.
Any sort of lead is
digging all the UEFA Champions League decor around the grounds, though. Jeez, let them run all the way up the field, why don't you? Literally ran the entire length of the field. See, that player movement's pretty realistic. Like, that's totally something I could see happening in a real game of football. Whew. Jeez, Daniel. Robert Firmino. Oh, thank you.
It is going to be a Dortmund free kick.
Yeah, it's about. It's about.
Manuel Akanji.
Yep, shoot.
No more time.
All right, on to the second half we go. All the guy is tired yet? You
and
betcha.
So the second half of this Champions League group stage match day one contest commences. Strong play here. Fabinho now. Henderson has it. Well, he's got plenty of space on the flank here.
No, no foul.
Illegal play.
Clean. Clean, son. Clean.
That
who's that, Lee Dixon?
Well, delivered into the box.
Oof. Hate to see it. 2-0. Si, senor. Obsessed with singing that song now.
2-0. Given away.
The ball roll, the most underrated skill in FIFA to have. Set you up for so much good. One more pass. Damn it.
Masterful piece of foiling. Matip now.
Man, Alexander Arnold's so young. I'm pretty sure he's like 20. Like, I'm pretty sure his parents drove him to his last Premier League game of the season. Not even gonna flex. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I'm just saying it's like he's so young. It's like I'm pretty sure he like just learned how to drive like not too long ago. I'll have to fact check that though. See how old he actually is. I'm pretty sure he's 20 though. So it's not like he's that young, but it's not like he's 18. Oh, you know, low-key, that was a pretty good touch. A lot of balls are pretty good in this game. Yeah. Wow, way to telegraph the pass.
Salah. And now Henderson. It's got to be.
What a save, son. Ooh, I'm liking this goalkeeper play. See, even kicking the ball downfield, you know, to the length of the width of the pitch is nice too. Because in Ultimate Team, I can never do it because it's either I would hit it right down the middle of the pitch, or I'd nail it straight out of bounds, and it would just drive me mad because I'm like I see my guy screaming down the width of the pitch and I can't get it to him because the gameplay mechanics just don't really allow for it, and I'm glad they started to fix that up a little bit, but he's on. Selfish play by myself again. Totally could have passed it off to Alcacer, who's just screaming down in the middle there. Going for that bicycle kick here. Definitely going for it. There it is. Well, not quite a bicycle kick, but Mahomes.
So there we have it.
No, Royce ain't coming. No, nobody's coming off. We're down. All our offensive weapons are on the field. No, he's coming off. No breaks. No caps. For those of you who are fans of Disney's The Incredibles, which is a phenomenal movie. If you haven't seen the second one, do yourself a favor. Please watch it. And especially if you haven't watched the first one, stop watching the stream right now and go watch Incredibles. do yourself a favor. You will not regret it. Best 2 hours I've ever spent on a movie. I mean, there's a lot of good movies out there, but Incredibles is also a must-see. I mean, come on. Come on, don't hold on to the ball, mates. See, I knew I was going to bust out. I was going to try to bust out the English accent, but it probably was not very good. Come on, keep her going. Oh, hey. Whoa. Don't get tired on me now, Marco.
Decisive clearance it was. Oxley Chamberlain.
Mane. Oxley Chamberlain. I will say defending definitely feels a little bit more difficult in FIFA 20, but I think the jury's still kind of out on that one. Oh, please tell me the keeper's charging. Oh, no way. Wow, that sucks. Well, that was a fun game. Let's see if we can squeeze in a quick game of Volta Football 2. Just to kind of show you guys another little preview of how that looks like if you haven't seen it already. It'll probably only take like 4 minutes. And plus, it's stuck on semi-pro difficulty too, so it's kind of quite easy to score and win. But you guys will see that in a second here. Alright, y'all. Enjoy the cutscenes.
Short one. You in?
All right, so hope y'all enjoyed that. Vinicius Jr. is kind of the featured player in the Volta Football story, I believe, too. But I guess we'll see. Jury's still kind of out on that one, too. I played the closed beta, and the Volta Football story, I got to play a decent part of it. Lots of fun. I think Volta Football is going to be the bomb, so stay tuned for that, y'all. Oof. It just adds in a certain dynamic of street ball banger. Sweet. Like I said, it's just the different flavor of football, you know? It's like you get NFL Street, you get NBA Street, you get... I don't even think they ever made a FIFA Street in truth. But now it feels like that, except a little bit more polished. Boing. Oh, we fluffed it, friends. But it's like, yeah, so you see some, I mean, did you see some of the moves in the cutscene? Because I want to learn how to do some of those. I tried learning one on the training pitch, like, a few weeks ago, back on a field near my hometown, and I guess I know how to do it to a certain extent, but wasn't exactly, like, the most professional-looking thing in the world, and whether or not I could do that in an actual game remains to be seen for sure. You know, long range. Yeah, figured not. Oi. Yeah, this looks like the game here, fellas. There we go. How about it? Yeah, when you're playing semi-pro AI, it's not exactly too crazy difficult. If you're experienced, if you're not experienced, nothing wrong with playing on semi-pro. That's what I started out as when I started playing FIFA 14, so. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't really think you can change the difficulty of this in particular, so. Jay-Zinho. Yes, that is a wonderful name. I totally love it. Alright guys, I just wanted to give you a little bit more flavor, a little bit more taste of FIFA 20 today. Kept it a little bit shorter just because that's just what the time constraints allowed for me today. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys haven't seen my video review of the demo, check it out on the channel. It's both on YouTube and on Twitch currently. So like I said, overall, like what I'm seeing in FIFA 20, I think it's making some progress each year, so it's good to go. Guys, thanks so much for watching again. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, whisper, follow, and or otherwise if you like what you're seeing, or comment below if you got any feedback for me. I'm always willing to hear it, good or bad. So thanks again for watching, guys. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.